This problem involves staying safe on a ship. Now let me explain the scenario to you. The bad guys have taken over the pier, as we can tell by the flag saying bad guys. They have a cannon which they can adjust to any angle they want between 0 and 180 degrees, and it can fire cannonballs with a velocity of 56 meters per second. Next to the cannon, there's this flagpole, and it has a known height of 30 meters. Now let's say we want to keep an eye on the bad guys, make sure we know what they're up to. Well, we don't want to get to within range of their cannon. We don't want to be able to be shot by this cannon. That's not fun. So what do we need to do? Well, first we need to calculate the range of the cannon to figure out how far this thing can shoot. And as a hint, range is optimized when this angle is equal to 45 degrees. But what then? What do we do after we've calculated the range of the cannon? Well, we need to keep our distance. But how do we do that? How do we know our distance? Well, luckily enough, there's this flagpole. If we look from the top of this flagpole to the bottom, we can measure this angle, beta. And as long as beta is pretty small, let's say less than 10 degrees, these are going to be very close to right angles, and we can do some trigonometry. Now, clearly, if the boat is really close to the shore, this flagpole will look very big. Beta will be large to our observer. And if the boat's very far away, beta will be small. The flagpole will look very small for far away. I want to know, at what value of beta can the cannon reach our ship? Now, this is a really tricky question. It involves a pretty complicated two-dimensional motion problem, as well as some trigonometry that we learned in the first unit. If you can put this all together and get the correct answer, I'll be very impressed.